to Undisputed. We are live from Los Angeles. I'm Jenny Taft here with Skip Bayless, Shannon Sharp. Good morning.
Hi.
How are you?
Hey, Skip, how you doing in the morning, Skip?
You know, a little bird told me that somebody prepped for today's show by studying his dating app, but I don't know. That's I was told that, but I don't know if it's true or not.
He's Skip, spreading these
is that possible? And it obviously wasn't me.
No.
It was somebody.
So now, yesterday you tried to be, you know, Skip Sharp.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Today you're Skip 6'9".
I envy you.
Stop dry snitching.
I envy you. You're my idol.
I'm over here.
You're my hero.
It wasn't me.
Yeah.
So. All right, Shannon, you're on your own today. We have a packed show today. I think we got to get to it. No more dating apps up. Is Aaron Rodgers on the decline, and will the Patriots go undefeated this season? But first, who is the best quarterback in the league right now? According to Pro Football Focus, Tom Brady is the highest rated quarterback this season. Coming in at number two is Dak Prescott, who was initially a third tier quarterback to start the season by these same rankings. Remember that. Dak is followed by Carson Wentz at number three, Russell Wilson at four, Deshaun Watson at five, and reigning MVP Patrick Mahomes came in at six.
What?
Shannon.
Six?
Yeah.
Was that a typo?
No.
Misprint?
Number six.
Six?
So this is the question, Shannon. Did they get this right?
Hell no.
Hell no.
And you know, once Patrick Mahomes was not at number one, nothing else even mattered to me.
Mm.
I don't care who was at 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10, 12, 13. It didn't matter.
Mm.
Because this is some bull jive, Skip Bayless, and you know it.
I don't know it.
I'm trying to figure out how can Patrick Mahomes have a higher completion percentage, a higher QBR, higher yards per attempt, more big plays, more touchdowns.
Mm.
How the same record, and he's rated, well, we based it on the potential. He has some throws that could have been intercepted. Now, did the ball get intercepted? It's a simple yes or no. Skip, sports is really about black and white. If you play basketball, did the ball go in the hoop?
Yep.
Yes or no?
Mm.
What if he'd have missed that shot? But he didn't miss.
Mm.
Oh, this could have been picked off. All I know is this. Patrick Mahomes has zero interceptions.
Mm.
There's no way. And it's almost like this. And sometimes I really hate even talking about Tom Brady, because if you critique Tom Brady, it always goes back. He got six Super Bowls. We're not talking about that.
Nope,
you can't take those six Super Bowls away.
No. Nope.
We're talking about the first three games of the regular season. And Skip Bayless said he's a big eye test guy.
Mm.
What do your eyes tell you? No one, even New England Patriots fans, will honestly say Tom Brady is playing better football than Patrick Mahomes.
Don't speak for New England fans.
No, Skip, there's no way. Stop it. There's no way. Because you love QBR.
Mm-hmm.
Skip says QBR is a stat that measures 0 to 100, and it takes in running and accountability.
Who leads the league?
Dak leads
the league. Thank you. Go ahead.
But
game over.
But Dak is not number one. I'm talking about I got to see Skip for me. Once my homeboy wasn't number one, I blacked out. I was like, oh.
You blacked
out? Yeah, I blacked out.
You're done.
Yeah.
You're taking this way too serious.
Yeah, no, I ain't taking it too serious.
You don't need to black out.
Patrick Mahomes has done something in his third year that no other quarterback has ever done. Three straight games in which he threw for 350 plus, three touchdowns, and zero interceptions.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not talking about to start the season. I'm talking about at any point in time during a season.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he's doing. He has more plays of 20 yards or more than anybody in the NFL.
Okay.
He has more touchdowns than anybody. He's 200 yards clear of the next closest in passing yards.
Mm.
And he's sixth based on the potential that he might turn the ball over because he got reckless.
Mm.
All I want to know, Skip, that when he threw the ball, did his guy catch it or did the other guy catch it?
Mm.
Because all I know is this. He has two guys in the top five in receiving yards.
Mm.
Nobody else can say that.
Okay.
So this is some bull. As a matter of fact, moving forward from this point on, I will not make reference to PFF.
Really? You got what? What are you gonna call it? Pro football?
I don't call it nothing because of bull jive.
Pro football farce.
I'm calling it bull jive.
Okay.
You know bull jive is short for.
I do. I just heard a whole lot of it coming across the table.
No, you didn't.
I'm having to like swim through.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't.
Okay, my turn.
Go ahead.
Before I unleash on everything you just said, allow me to ask all of us to just step back for a second and think about the perspective of this. Think about the fact that even though this is a small sample size, and even though the New England Patriots have, we know they played the Dolphins and the Jets, even though those are division rivals for them.
And don't forget the Steelers.
Well, I'm just saying, but the Steelers, I still think they're credible on defense, but whatever. I'll give you that. Small sample size. And this survey starts off by underlining the fact, small sample size. But still, given all that, given the fact that Tom Brady is 42 years of age, given the fact that people have written him off and sent him into the sunset, dating all the way back to that 2014 Monday night nightmare at Kansas City, 41-14. Didn't it start there where people were writing him off, trying to retire him? But given all that, what's happened in the interim, and I'm not going back into history, I'm just trying to keep this in perspective for you, but Tom Brady has had, since then, 4 Super Bowl appearances, and he's won 3 of them. Okay, wait. I'm saying that happened since he started getting retired by his critics. And now this has happened. Albeit just 3 games in, he's ranked number 1 of 32 starting quarterbacks because he's just been flawless. He's been flawless. There's been no negative plays. He hasn't thrown one ball that could have been intercepted. He hasn't fumbled one ball that should have been recovered by the opposition. He has been flawless. And what's the breakdown here? It's reminiscent of his elite play from 2015 to 2017. He's off to that kind of start. You have to accept that. You have to honor that, albeit early on, because I'm in awe of that. He's ranked number 1, and you will not give him 1 ounce of credit, and I'm going to give him just a little bit of credit for his first 3 games. Now, let's move to your man, Patrick Mahomes boy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, Tyler, Texas, Glenview, Georgia. I don't know. I don't know how that happened.
Don't worry about
Georgia.
It.
He's from Tyler, Texas, but he's your homeboy. But here's the point. I told you going into this season, he's in danger of becoming a caricature of himself. He's like a Globetrotter, if people remember the Globetrotters, playing quarterback.
Yes.
He's like becoming the Meadowlark Lemon of quarterbacks.
And he's making defense the Washington Nationals.
Okay. You could be right about that because on occasion, especially when he goes bombs away, that happens. But there are a lot of trick shots in his arsenal. There's a lot of no looks. I'm waiting for the behind the back between the legs. It may be coming. And it's a little bit too much whipped cream for me because it's just a dangerous league to do that in because you're daring your opponents to get even with you at some point. We talked about Baker Mayfield. We're going to talk about him later in the show where if you keep swaggering the NFL to death, they'll swagger back at you, right? So all of a sudden, the reason they are downgrading him is this is the sentence right here. After ranking 2nd at avoiding negative graded throws last season, Mahomes ranks just 19th in the same statistical category this season. Negatively graded throws are 3 that he threw that the opponents had their hands on, and it was more intended for the opponent than his receiver. That's a negatively graded throw. Were they picked? No.
Okay, so what are we talking about?
Okay, was it a throw that could have been intercepted, that probably should have been intercepted? Yes, yes, and yes.
You see, Skip.
Yes.
But that's not
how he didn't do that. He was 2nd in the league in lack of those plays last year.
But Skip, that's not how it works. That's not how it works.
That's how they work.
But I'm saying, you factored in, he's 42, so they not use, well, I need to call EEOC because they're discriminating against Tom Brady because of his age. Mm. They don't factor that in there.
No.
They didn't say anything about no age.
No. They said, I'm just
3
saying.
3 games into the season.
Okay, but again, I'm just trying to keep Brady in perspective because you've tried to retire him for about 3 years.
I don't know anything about age. I don't know how old Patrick Mahomes is. I don't know how old Dak is. All I am is that I've seen them all play this year, 3 games. And the numbers and my eyes tell me Patrick Mahomes has played that position better than all the other quarterbacks, period.
Okay, and yet it points out he still has the league-leading big-time throw percentage. Okay, so spectacular plays, you got it. Negatively graded plays, I got it. And it could become problematic down the road.
But Skip, how about this here? Skip, there's a bridge out.
Mm-hmm.
Can we wait till we cross that bridge? Can we wait till we get to the bridge? You want us to cross something, but we're not even there yet.
Is the bridge damaged? Could be.
I would like to get there. They might have the bridge repaired by the time I get there.
Is there dynamite and the fuse has been lit under the bridge?
Ain't no telling.
The fuse is burning.
All I'm saying is this. The guy has 10 touchdowns, 0 interceptions. Mm-hmm. Tom Brady has 7 touchdowns, 0 interceptions. He's 300 yards clear of Tom.
But they're grading throws, and Tom's throws have been perfect, 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 perfect. He's number one. You got to give him some credit for that.
Give him some credit, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, hold on, hold on. Let me see here. Oh, Tom Brady. What Tom Brady. Yeah. Give him some credit. When my homeboy is almost 2 yards to throw more. So he doing a lot of James White. My guy throwing the ball 40 and 50 yards down the field. When you're throwing the ball to James White and James Burkhead, of course you got to go and get intercepted on swing passes.
Your guy is the best at doing that, but that's not the totality of playing winning quarterbacks.
Skip, did you see him throw the ball to Damian Williams?